All right. Good afternoon from Fine. So this is the second group of from Fine student, okay? Most of the school you already finished your diagnostic test, That one not so important one. I don't worry so much like your diagnostic test. Just a practice only, okay? So don't over worry lah. So the most important you must keep moving forward lah. Keep moving, continue to study. Okay, the last few months here is very important, you know. Now July already. July, August, September, October, November, you got a few more months. Okay. These few months you must go full swing already. Study. You really struggle these few months, you will change your future. You can guarantee your future, you know. So this few months is very important for you all. So this few months cannot relax already. You have to start from July. Okay. Continue to study until December, and then January come your SPM. Okay, so remember now, stay strong to fight for your future. Okay, study hard, get good result. Okay, right. Our last lesson we saw radioactivity chapter lesson 2. Right. Okay, come, I share the paper with you all. So let's look at the paper first. Okay. This is a paper, okay. Our last lesson, we focus on this detectors of radioactive, right? Photographic plates, gold leaf electroscope, all this. You all remember or not? How many detectors you all have learned? How many? Erase, can you tell me how many radioactive detectors you have learned?
Wait,
how many?
Let me count.
You look at a paper, you count how many altogether. Photographic plate, gold leaf electroscope, then you have spark counter, granite, spark counter, you have Geiger Muller tube, GM tube, right? Number four. And number five is cloud chamber. So this is the last one now. Cloud chamber. Correct not? Okay. Okay, now I want to ask some questions on this detector la. Okay. My question is very simple, you listen. Which detector can only detect alpha? Can only detect alpha. So, what are the detector that can only detect alpha? Hua Suming, you know the answer or not? Try Hua Suming.
Spark counter.
Spark counter one, okay, one only. Can detect alpha only one. Spark counter, what else?
Gold leaf electroscope.
Yeah, gold leaf electroscope. Any other?
No more.
Gold leaf electroscope, spark counter, any more?
No more.
Then can detect alpha only one. So only two, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay, only two, Okay, so my next question. Which detector can detect all three radiation, alpha, beta, gamma, can also detect one. All three can be detected one. So, what are the detector can detect all the three? Bigachuan? Bigachuan, which detector can detect all the three, alpha, beta, and gamma? Gajuan, do you know or not? Tan Yuan En, do you know or not? Tan Yuan En, what detector can detect all three? Yuan En?
Cloud chamber.
Cloud chamber, what else?
Geiger Muller.
Geiger Muller tube.
Muller tube.
Any more?
photographic plate.
Photographic plate. So remember now, this tray can detect all alpha, beta, and gamma one. Okay, huh? The next question. Out of these five detectors in your syllabus, right? Out of five detectors using one concept to detect, you know, what concept used by four out of five detectors? What concept they use? What concept they use to detect the radiation? This question you all must know. Okay, Jiu Tong.
Yes, sir.
What concept the detector use to detect radiation?
Ionization.
Yes, correct. Very good. Ionization. They must use a concept ionization. And there's one not using ionization one. So we call it photographic plate. So this photographic plate are not using ionization now. So the photographic plate are using what? What concept they use? Song Homan.
So can you repeat the question?
Okay. Photographic plates are using what concept to detect radiation? What concept they use?
Radioactive radiation.
Photographic plate can use to detect detect radiation ma. So but they use what concept? They are not using ionization, but using another concept. What concept?
The degree of darkening.
What? Darkening. Correct. Darkening. The one darkening is given what process? Name one ma. What is the name?
Forget already.
Forget already. Yonan, you know not? Tan Yonan.
Which one?
The photographic plate, using what concept?
Radiation.
No lah, not radiation lah. Jiu Tong, do you know not? Photographic plate using what concept? No, you can read here. The answer is here. Can you find? Okay. They use what? They use chemical change, chemical reaction. Okay. Chemical change. Is it here? Chemical change. So, when chemical change, it will cause the plate become darkened, become dark color already. Understand? So, all these things, you must know, you know. Okay. So, this one finished already. And my next question. What is alpha decay? Alpha decay is what? What is alpha decay? What assuming alpha decay is what? What is alpha decay?
Alpha decay is alpha decay is
is what? This is a process where this is a process where what is released? In alpha decay, what is released?
Alpha particles energy.
Yes, alpha particles is released, right? Okay. Not finished yet. During alpha decay, what happened to the proton number? What happened to the nucleon number?
Proton number decreases.
Proton number decreases, why?
Nucleon number decreases also.
Yes. Decreased by how many? Proton number decreases by?
Two.
Then nucleon number decreases by?
Four.
Here minus two, here minus four. So remember that, Apple, are you there? Apple?
Yeah.
Okay, Apple, can you tell me what happened during beta decay?
Proton number increase.
Proton number plus one increases one. Then nucleon number?
Change.
Nucleon number, what happened?
Does not change.
Yes, does not change. This number not change because here is zero. So this number will not change. Here negative one, so here plus one. Okay, huh? Okay, next question. Belton, are you there? Belton?
Yes,
Belton. Okay, what happened in gamma emission? During gamma emission, what happened?
The atomic number of the atom does not change.
Yes, does not change. Never change. Proton number never change. Nucleon number also never change. Okay, gamma. Okay, next is I want to ask this. Chukaiji, are you there? Chukaiji?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, Chukaiji, what is the meaning of half life? Half life is what? What is half life?
The
half life.
For yeah. Half is original activity.
Yeah, it's the time taken. Time taken for the number of activities to reduce by half, right? There are three ways to state the answer actually, half life. Is time taken for the number of atoms to reduce by half, number of atoms. The second one you can say is time taken for the mass of the unstable nucleus to reduce by half, for the mass. And the last one is like Kaiji said, time taken for the number of activities of the unstable nucleus to reduce to half. So everything reduced to half life is called half life. Okay. All right. Okay. Now we need to answer all the questions. I think we just go too quickly. I think some of the questions we have discussed already once. So the one I don't explain already. Number one, radioactivity is emission of energetic particle from unstable nucleus. Answer C. This one I think we discussed already. Okay. Number two, which of the following not true about radioactive? Not true. So the answer is increasing of mass. This one never happened. Because during the radioactive process, the decay process, the mass actually reduced, keep reducing half, getting lesser and lesser. It never increased one, understand? The rest of correct now, producing radioactive rays, correct? Produce more stable nucleus, memang more stable. Because finally, you want to be totally stable, then die. Okay? And last, spontaneous and randomly, meaning that cannot be predicted one when it happens. So it's spontaneous and randomly, okay? Number three, this time we discussed already one, so I go fast. X-ray is not radioactive. Alpha, yes. Beta, yes. Gamma, yes. But not X-ray. Okay, All right, number four. Not radioactive detector. So, mount this cross tube. This one you learn in your electronic chapter four. Spark counter, cloud chamber, GM tube, yes. Except C. Okay, Okay, number five. Also, I think we have discussed. Just have a look. Which of the following device can detect all three? So it's cloud chamber. Cloud chamber can detect alpha, beta, gamma. Okay. Spark counter can only detect alpha. Gold leaf electroscope also can detect alpha only. Okay. Then number six. Most of the radioactive detector make use of ionization. Just now I have asked you, right? They use the concept of ionization. Okay. except photographic plate yield chemical change. Okay, number 7. Which of the following device cannot detect all three? Cannot detect all three, so it's glow leaf electroscope. This one can detect alpha only. Remember these three, cloud chamber, photographic plates, Geiger Muller tip can detect all three one, okay? Remember the name. Okay, yeah, number 8, also I think we have discussed, right? So what happened to the gold leaf when you bring alpha here? Okay, alpha particle has strong ionization, so it will ionize the A molecule to become positive ion and negative ion. Then the negative ion will be attracted to the positive, it come down to neutralize the positive. Once a positive charge here been neutralized, right? So no repulsion force already. So the gold leaf will close up. So it will drop now. So the answer is deflection decreases. Okay, huh? Okay, number 9. Detected by spark counter, so it's alpha. Okay, this one okay, huh? The other day, we stopped at what question? Anyone? Kaiji, do you remember or not? Which question we stopped the other day? You Kaiji?
14.
14, okay. 1-4,
Yes.
Okay, okay, thank you. Okay, very fun. Number 10, cannot detect gamma, so it's gold leaf. Gold leaf electroscope only can detect alpha. So gamma cannot. This one can, okay? 11, threat produced in the cloud chamber is because of condensation. The smoke is produced by condensation of alcohol vapor on the ion, okay? 12, which of the following about alpha, beta, gamma is correct? So answer A, alpha is helium, beta is fast moving electron, must remember, no. Gamma is electromagnetic wave, so make sure you know all this, Okay, alpha is what, beta is what, gamma is what, very important to know, okay? 13, which of the following statement about alpha can deflect by electromagnetic field? This is correct, okay? Alpha carry charge. When it carry charge means it can be deflected by electromagnetic field, okay, then detected by electromagnetic field, okay, Okay, number 14, I think we stop here. Which of the following show alpha has charge, okay, ionizes A molecule, okay, when it can ionize the A molecule, it show that alpha carry charge, correct not? It must have charge so we can ionize the A molecule. I believe that there is one more answer here, number 14. Can anyone tell me which one more answer, correct one is which one? Beside B, there's another answer. Apple? Beside B, one more correct answer is which one? Apple?
D.
Donkey. Alpha stopped by thin sheet of paper. Yes, also correct. Okay, alpha memang can stop by paper, ma. What about C? C, is it correct? No. Sorry, Apple. Cannot accept D, you know, because he said, show alpha particle has charge. It stopped by paper doesn't mean that it's never show it has charge, you know. So this one cannot, know. This one never show alpha carry charge, you know, actually. But whether, even though this is correct, but it doesn't show the alpha carry charge. The answer should be C, B and C. Can be deflected by magnetic field. Yes, correct. When can deflected by magnetic field, you show that carry charge, correct not? You must have charge that we can be deflected in the electric field and in the magnetic field, understand? Okay, Okay, next question. This one. Which comparison is correct about the speed alpha, beta, gamma? This one. Then you all tell me the answer. Comparison about the speed. Who faster than who? And who faster than who? Huh? Yeah. Divish? Divish, please come out, Divish.
Yes, sir.
Comparing the speed. Who faster than who and who faster than who? Who has a fastest speed now? Alpha, beta, gamma.
I think gamma.
Gamma fastest, isn't it? Second?
Yeah. Beta.
Beta. Then the slowest?
Alpha.
Yes, correct. So the answer, no answer here. So you write down this answer. There's no answer now. So the answer, you follow this now. Gamma faster than beta, beta faster than alpha. So the answer should be this one. Nah. There's no answer here. So you follow this answer, okay? Okay, number 16. Then this one. How? The answer already there. Alpha, beta, gamma. Then you see the arrow. Arrow show that ascending order. Ascending order means this one very weak, stronger. So this is penetration power. Penetration power, this is small, this is medium, this is high penetration power. Okay, huh? Let me test you all first, huh? Chuan He, Chuan He, are you there? Chuan He? Chuan He? Chuan He, are you there?
Yes.
Okay, Chuan He, I want to ask you, alpha penetration power very low. Alpha can stop by what? How to stop alpha? How to stop alpha particles? Kai Chi, how to stop alpha? You Kai Chi.
Paper.
Just a piece of paper can stop alpha. Then how to stop beta? Kai Chi.
Aluminium
can stop beta. Then what about gamma? How to stop gamma?
2 cm of lead.
Yes, correct. You need few centimeter of lead, very thick. No. To stop gamma, not easy, you need lead, LEAD, lead. Okay, number 17. Which one is the answer? Which of the following has the highest penetrating power? William Chen. William, can come out or not? William, please. William, all this no sound one. William, okay, I know you type. Okay, William, which one has the highest penetrating power? Can you type your answer? Has the highest penetrating power. Which one has the highest penetrating power, William? Type your answer. Yes, correct. Donkey. Okay. Gamma. Thank you, William. Okay. 18. Which following statement is correct for gamma? Which one is correct for gamma? Which one is correct for gamma? Huixin. Yao Huixin. Which one is correct about gamma?
Yes, ABC. Sir.
Say it again. Huixin, which one?
C.
Yes, correct. C. Good. Okay. And electromagnetic wave. Gamma is electromagnetic wave. Okay. Correct. C. Okay. Number 19. 19, the diagram already show you the answer already, no? You see, huh? This one, Y stop by paper. So this is alpha, stop by paper. Z stop by aluminium. So this is beta. Gamma, this one, X stop by lead. So this is gamma, no? So X is gamma, Y is alpha, Z is beta. So you know the answer already, huh? Alright, so the answer is C. Okay, C. Can I understand now? So remember now, this diagram came out in the SVM few times already. They ask you this is what, this is what, this is what, you must know because it's very, very basic question. Okay. Yeah, 20. Answer already there. This following statement characteristics of gamma. It is an electromagnetic wave, okay? Remember, lah, gamma is electromagnetic wave, okay? Gamma is not particle. Gamma is a wave, you know, electromagnetic wave, okay? 21 also got answer. Which of the following about alpha, beta is correct? About alpha, beta, so they carry charge, have electrical charge, correct, lah? Alpha and beta carry charge. Okay, come. Rian, are you there, Rian? Rianna.
Yeah, sir.
Rian, can you tell me now? We say alpha, beta got charge, right? Alpha carry what charge?
Alpha carry positive charge.
Yes, correct. Then beta? Beta carry what charge?
Negative charge.
Yes, correct. Negative charge. Okay, very good. Thank you. Okay, 22. A group of radioactive are forced to pass through a magnetic field. Okay, which diagram show the track is correct? The alpha, beta, gamma go through magnetic field. Which diagram is correct? Now you see the paper now. Which diagram is correct now? Which diagram is correct now? Alpha, beta, gamma. So which diagram is correct? Yong, can you come out or not? Yong?
Sir, yes.
Yong, okay, can you tell me what? Which diagram is correct?
Wait, one minute.
Alpha, beta, gamma. Which diagram is correct?
Give me 1 minute.
Yeah, I'm fine.
I go find the paper first. I will tell.
Okay, go. Go and find the paper.
Okay. Wait, Question number 20 something.
22. Ask you which diagram is correct.
Donkey.
Donkey. I show here already. Donkey is still correct.
I don't know.
Okay.
Donkey or C? A.
So, answer A,
okay.
You must know now, this diagram many times already, so it's A,
I terbalik beta and alpha already, gamma, correct.
Gamma straight, alpha here, beta. How to differentiate alpha, beta? Okay, alpha, beta must deflected in opposite direction, and then you must know, alpha deflected less. This one deflect a little bit only. Beta deflected a lot. Then you must know the reason why. Why alpha deflected less, beta deflected so much? Why like that? Why like that? Song Ho Man, please come out, please. Why alpha deflected less, beta deflect so much? Why?
Find it.
Why alpha is here? Alpha only deflect a little bit. Beta deflected so much. Why?
Why? I guess already. I forget already. I guess.
Okay.
I guess it's the
Because their mass is different, I guess.
Yes, correct. The mass is different. But can you tell me now, which one the mass bigger, which one mass smaller?
Alpha mass bigger and then beta mass smaller.
Yes, correct. Okay. This one bigger mass. Bigger mass means the momentum, inertia bigger, so difficult to reflect. This one very light, the mass very small, electron very small, so very easy to deflect. Okay, that is the reason. All right. 23. Why the size of deflection of beta greater than beta? I have just explained to you. So now they ask a question again. Size of deflection beta greater than alpha. This is because of what? What is the answer? Okay, come, let's call the bond Guang Yao. Who is Guang Yao? Name Guang Yao, I never see before one. Keep changing name, I don't know who. Li Ka Chuan, Li Ka Chuan, come up, please. Li Ka Chuan. Li Ka Chuan. Okay, lah. Listen, still knows. Okay, I think what she typed there. Li Ka Chuan, 23, one answer, Li Ka Chuan. 23, this one, one answer. Why the size of beta deflected greater than the alpha? Why? Li Ka Chuan, what answer? 23. 23, what answer? The answer A, yes, correct. Dikachon, correct, huh? Dikachon, thank you. The mass alpha greater than the beta, okay? Yeah. 24. Now, which of the following has similar characteristics to beta? Beta actually similar to who? Pelton? Pelton, actually beta similar to who?
Electron.
Yes, electron, correct. P, electron. Okay, 25. Diagram shows an absorber placed between the radioactive source and the GM tube, not G tube, GM tube, okay? GM tube, okay. The radioactive source is here. So this is a GM tube, can detect the radiation. Now you put something here to absorb the radiation. So remember now, you see the result like this. Okay, the result. The result show like this, you know. Without absorber 500, you get 500 cal. With thin paper, it dropped to 220. You put aluminium, it dropped further to 50. When you put lead, it only dropped to 48. So now they ask you, which types of radiation emitted? Also, SPM question and all. How to see? Okay. Tan Yuan Nan, do you know the answer? Tan Yuan Nan? Which
dog,
one?
Dog.
Dog. Not dog. Okay, now my come listen. Let me explain to you all. Okay, without absorber mean nothing to block. Nothing to block, then the reading is very high, 500. Because all alpha, beta, gamma also can. Because no absorber, everything got, so the cow is very high. Then after that, you put a piece of thin paper. So it suddenly dropped to 220. So it means confirmed got alpha already. Because the alpha blocked by the paper, that's why it dropped suddenly from 500 drop to 220, because the alpha cannot go through. So from here, drop to 220 means confirm got alpha. Then Then for 200, you put aluminium, right? It suddenly dropped to 50, also drop a lot. So confirm here got beta. Because when you put aluminium, it can block beta. That's why the reading suddenly drop to 50. No? So confirm got alpha, got beta. Okay, then gamma, you see, you put lead to block the gamma. But the reading only dropped by 2. The reading dropped 2 liters. A little bit only, it is not counted. Okay, from 50 drop to 48 only, so we cannot say over there got gamma. No, cannot. You see, like this one drop a lot, one you can say, like this one drop a lot, got alpha, this one drop a lot, got beta, this one drop a little bit only. So from here, we say no gamma because the drop is too low, too little, so cannot. So the answer is only got alpha and beta. Yeah, understand? So got alpha and beta here lah. Understand? Harry Young, understand? What is no sound? No sound means they're not listening.
Yes.
Yes. You see, never listen. I ask you, then he said,
yeah.
Yeah.
Got listen.
What I say just now?
You say what? Okay. The aluminium, right? Is blocked by the beta particles.
Yes.
So the thin paper is lead block blocked by the
You put thin paper, it can block what?
Alpha.
So got alpha beta. Then why put lead here last block gamma ma? But why no gamma?
Because put lead,
you can block gamma ma. Why no gamma? Why no gamma?
Because they don't have gamma.
You are very young, man. You don't play that way. Because the drop here la, too small, 50 drop to 48 only, so it's not significant, understand? When a drop is not significant, so we cannot say got gamma. Unless you got 50 drop to 10, like that, you can say got gamma.
Okay.
50 drop 48, no, cannot. Okay?
Okay.
You understand or not?
Yes.
All these people here understand. For swimming, do you understand?
Yes.
For swimming, understand? Okay, come. We move on. 27. D. Which types of nuclear reaction are this? Let me explain. You haven't learned, you know. Nuclear heavier after reaction. Okay. Alpha, beta, gamma all cause the substance to become lighter. This one alpha, beta, decay, gamma emission all become lighter one. Okay. Nuclear fission. Fission, the word fission means combine. Mean combine. Can you jot down here? Fusion means combine. When you combine two small particles together, definitely it becomes heavier. So nuclear fission in lesson 4, you learn later. So fission process can produce a bigger or heavier nucleus. Fusion, because you combine two small ones to become one big one. Okay, that is called fusion. Okay, 28. What answer? Admit a beta. What is the change in the nuclear number? When you admit beta, what is the nuclear number change? See? Okay, beta is negative 1, 0 electron. So nuclear number here, because here is 0, so what is the answer? What is the change in the nuclear number? Tan wen gang. What is the change in the nuclear number? Chan Wen Gang. Okay, come, let me see. Answer donkey. Yes, correct. Chan Wen Gang does not change. Okay, correct, Chan Wen Gang. 29. In the following equation, decay polonium nucleus, you see, this one minus 4, this are minus 2, you already know this is what? This is what, eh? Helium 2, 4, this is what? Okay, come. Tan Wen Xiang, Tan Wen Xiang, ah. Tan Wen Xiang, this one is what, Tan Wen Xiang? Helium 2, 4 is what? Tan Wen Xiang. No sound. For swimming, okay, for swimming, please. Can you see this one? This is what for swimming?
This one is
what?
Yes, alpha.
Yes, correct, alpha. Okay, thank you. Okay, 30. Following equation represent the decays of helium and sodium. This one no changes, this one plus one. So here plus one, so here must be minus one. No? So this is what then? This one electron, okay? So I don't want to waste time already, like this one electron. Okay, 31. The following equation represent the decays of plumbum nucleus. The equation like this, Okay? What are X and Y? They want you to find X and Y. This is what? This is what? X is what? Y is what? Tan Yuan En, what is X? What is Y? Tan Yuan En, this equation, this one, X is what? Y is what? X is what?
X is beta.
Beta. Why then?
Y is gamma.
Gamma la, because no charge one ma gamma lo. So this is beta, this is gamma la. Okay. So the answer is this one beta, this one gamma la. Okay. Okay, 21 done. So answer is beta gamma. Okay, 32. Look at the equation. Then you tell me the answer. Polonium decay and admit alpha. You see, polonium start from here, admit alpha. Alpha is helium 2,4 la. So here 2,4 means this one minus 4. So it's 2,1,2. This one minus 2. So it's 82. This one you don't know the name, you put X. Okay. And it's saying the new nucleus means this one, 82,2,1,2. Decay again, admit a beta. Then. This one, you take from here, put it here. Release beta, negative 1, 0. So this number, here negative 1, so here is 83, must be plus 1. Negative 1 plus 53, you get 82. Then here 0, so you never affect 212, still the same. So the final answer is 83, 212. Okay, so the answer is C. This one, 83, 212. This one you must know, wait. This equation that you must know, since you study chemistry and physics also you study, you must know this one. Okay? All right. 33. Now the equation also come out already. Okay? You can use the same concept to answer. So, got answer already, Nucleus, this nucleus decay, admit 2 alpha. 2 alpha is here, this 2 alpha. And a beta, this is 1 beta. 2 alpha, 1 beta. So meaning that this one become 83. Because 83, no, 85, sorry. 85 minus 1 plus 2, no, sorry. Here is 4, you know, got 2. 4. So this is 83 now. Because here is 4. 4 minus 1, so it's 3. 3 plus 63, so you get 86. Okay? And then 8. 8 means here is 200, no? Because 8 plus 200 equals 208. And then he said this one, he can again admit gamma and beta. So you take this one, put it down here, dk beta, gamma. Beta is this one, gamma no charge one. So when here negative 1, 0 beta, so this one 84, 200. So the answer is 84, 200. Okay, hey, make sure you know all this, huh? Yeah, all right, 34 got answer already. How to get the answer? Both alpha beta are produced when 92, 3, 4 decay to 92, 218. How many alpha and beta are produced? The answer is 4 alpha, 10 beta. But how to get this answer then? So you need to write the equation and then do the calculation now. So I show you the answer now. How to get 4 and 10. So the answer is here. Okay. So you write the equation. 90, 2, 3, 4 go to 92, 218. This one plus 2. Then you say release alpha and beta, but you don't know how many alpha you put x, you don't know how many beta you put y. So this is alpha, you put x, and you don't know how many, this is beta, you put y. Then first use a nuclear number first, 2, 3, 4 equal 218 times 4x plus 4x plus y times 0. So you get this one. Take the nuclear number first, then you get this equation. So here 0. Solve everything, so you get the x is 4. So x is alpha, so got 4 alpha. Then beta, take the proton number at the bottom. 90 equal 92 plus 2x plus y times negative 1. So you get this equation. Negative y, bring to the left, become positive. So here 92, this one x is 4, substitute. 90 bring over to minus, so you get 10. 10 is y, so y is beta. So the answer is 4 alpha, 10 beta. Okay, please jot down the answer. Make sure you know how to calculate. Okay. Okay, question 35. Yeah, 35. Same method. V92, 232 decay to 90, 220. Write the equation and then find. The question says admit alpha and beta. So how many alpha, how many beta? So the answer is 3 alpha, 4 beta. You do like just now, you follow the method like just now, okay? Write the equation. Put x for alpha, y beta, okay? So you do like this, Yeah, I don't want to give you answers straight away, okay? You calculate yourself, can or not? What is the answer? I'll write this equation. 92, 232 decay to 90, 220 got alpha, got beta. How many alpha do you know? You put x. How many beta do you know? Put y. Then use the equation. 232 equal 220 plus 4x plus y times 0. Okay. Then you get all this answer. Understand it, So use nuclear number, you solve, you get x is 3, so it's 3 alpha. Then use a proton number, you form this equation, substitute the x, so you get y 4. So y is beta, so the 4 beta, 3 alpha, 4 beta, okay? Okay, come. Question 36. Yeah. Okay, from this graph, they ask you to find the number of alpha and beta. So how many alpha, how many beta? So you see here, here is nucleon number. Okay, mean 2, 3 is here, nucleon number. Then here is proton number. So meaning that this U is 92 and 2, 3, 8. Nucleon proton number is 92. Nucleon number 2, 3, 8. So it's here. La. Then from here, it go down to thorium. This thorium is 90 proton number. Nucleon number 2, 3, 4. Then from here, you know already. Minus 2. Here minus 4. So here must be pair alpha. La. Because after you release alpha, right? Proton number minus 2. Nucleon number minus 4, so this one alpha, okay? Then here, from here go to here, right? You can see now, from 90 go to 91. Then this 2, 3, 4 never change. They mean that this is beta, 1 beta. The number plus 1, proton number at 1, 91. But nucleon number no changes. So this is 1 beta. Here is another beta. So one box is 1 beta. So here got 2 beta. Then here another alpha. Because this one same like this one. So 1 alpha, 2 alpha, 3 alpha. And then here 1 beta, 2 beta. Okay. So the answer is 3 alpha, 2 beta. Okay. Understand? Huh? You understand? Huh? Tan Yong Kang, understand? Who is Tan Yong Kang? Ang Yao Ping, can you understand or not? Ang Yao Ping. Ang Yao Ping. Helping can, okay, can, okay, good. Okay, come, next question. 37. Half-life, there is the answer. Half-life is time taken for its activity to be half. I want to ask you again, I want to make sure everyone know what is half-life, you know. Okay, beside this answer, half-life is time taken for activity to be half. Okay, another two answer can be given is what? Not here, I want you to tell me. Half-life beside this time taken for activity to be half. Another answer is what? Delton? Delton,
time beside, taken.
Beside time taken for activity to be half, what else?
Time taken for the activity of radioactive fall to half.
Yeah, it's already here. I want you to tell me another answer. It's not here one. Same meaning one, same meaning like this one. Half-life is what? It's time taken for?
Yes.
And your name? Half-life, beside this answer, another answer is what?
The time taken for half of the unstable atoms to decay.
Yes, half of the atom to decay. That's one. Number of activity, half. Number of atom, half. One more, Tanyanan. One more is what? One is activity, one is number of atom, one more. Eh? One more answer is what? Liao Xing Xiang. Liao Xing Xiang.
Yeah.
Liao Xing Xiang, one more answer is what? Half life is time taken for activity to be half. Number of atom to be half. One more answer. Half-life got three definition.
So
yes.
The time taken for the mass to be half.
Yes, correct. So mass, number of atom or number of activities all together three now. Okay, thank you. You're not okay. All right. 38. Okay, 38, the answer B lah. Graph. Following number of atoms against the time. So the number of atoms must keep reducing one, getting lesser, 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 lesser. So you must reduce one, you know. But it never touches zero here, remember? It must go down like this, but getting lesser, but it never reach zero. So the answer B, all right? Okay, 39. This is a very simple calculation. Recorder record 160 pulses per second. The half-life, 5 days. What is the reading after 15 days? After 15 days, okay? Yeah, so you just do like that. 160 after 5 days, drop to 80. Another 5 days, drop to 40. Another 5 days, it becomes 20, okay? Why stop at 20? Harry Young. Why stop at 20, Harry? Harry, come out, please. Why stop at 20? Harry disappeared. William, William Chen, why stop at 20? William? Yeah, let's see what William say. Why I ask you, William, why stop at 20, William? Why stop at here? Why must stop at 20, right? Why don't continue? Xing Xiang, Liao Xing Xiang, why stop at 20? I see, William, you keep answer. Has been decayed. No one, not the answer. No, I'm asking you why we stop at
20. It asked for. It asked for 15 days.
Yes, correct, Xing Xiang, thank you. 15 days, ma. So 15 days, so stop at here. So the answer 20, Very young, understand? Okay, 40. Okay, question 40. Okay, I'll show you the whole answer. Okay, you're going to understand it. Diagram shows a graph activity against a time. So here is number of activity, here is time. So from here you can find the half-life, you know. You see from 250 drop to 180 is half. So the time taken now from here to here is 3 hours. So half-life is 3 hours. 256, half is 128 mark. So the time is 3 hours. Once you know the time of half-life, so you can continue. 256. 3 hours, 128. Another 3 hours, 64. Another 3 hours, 32. Another 3 hours, 16. Okay, because it said 12 hours now. 12 hours means 3, 3, 3, 3, 4 times that. Right? So it stopped at 16. So the final answer is 16. Okay. So make sure you understand this, huh? Rian, understand or not? Rian?
Yeah, sir.
Good. Okay. Apple, do you understand? Apple.
Yes, teacher.
Understand, huh?
Yeah.
Okay, come. Question 41. Okay, today we stop at 9 o'clock now, because some of you still got exam tomorrow. Okay, Gajah Berang and Notre Dame also got. Okay, so let them go and study a bit now. Okay, we stop at 9 o'clock. Okay, 41. 41, this answer is not correct. I don't copy away. But I want you to tell me why it's not correct. The answer is not correct. Don't copy. Okay. Radioactive source at half-life 8 hours. What is the percentage of atom to decay after 24 hours? So very straightforward. So you put 100. When given in percentage, right? So you start with 100%. Half-life 8 hours. So after 8 hours, it becomes half, 50%. Another 8 hours, it becomes half again, 25%. Another 8 hours, it becomes half, 12.5%. So 24 hours, so we stop here. Lor. 24 hours. But the answer, you see the question, what is the percentage of atom to decay after 24 hours? Lor? Atom to decay means already decay or not yet decay one. Now, Rian, if the question says, what is the percentage of atom to decay after 24 hours? Mean already decay or not yet decay one. Rian?
Already decay.
Yaka. Percentage of atom to decay after 24 hours to decay. Huixin, how do you think, Huixin? This sentence show that it's already decay or not decay one. Haven't decay, it's going to decay one. Huixin?
Haven't decay.
And then now Huixin say haven't decay one. The good friend Rian say already decay. So fight now, two of you. What about you, Apple? Apple Lau? Apple Lau?
Not yet decay.
So you say not yet decay one now? Yes, correct. It's not yet decay one. The meaning of the English means here, what is the percentage of atom to decay? To decay means it's going to decay one after 24 hours. Going to decay means the remaining now, that means not decay yet. So the answer is 12.5. So this 12.5% means the remaining now. The remaining, this one will going to be decay one no? After 24 hours, left 12.5% to be decay, going to decay. So the answer is A. Not D. D, you minus from 100 is 87.5. This one is already decay one. 87.5 is already decay. Okay? If going to decay one is 12.5%. So the answer is, based on my understanding of the English, is going to decay one. Okay? Because it said to decay, you mean not just happen one, it's 12.5%. So the answer A, You agree or not? Liao Xingxiang, agree or not?
Me.
Agree or not? Because the sentence said to decay means I'm not yet decay one. Song Homan, you agree? Song Homan. Song Homan disappeared already.
No, I still got.
So you agree with the answer or not?
Yes.
Okay, so the answer is 12.5 to decay one. Okay, 42. This one very straightforward lah. Recorder record 60 pulses per second. Half-life 24 second. What is the reading 24 second before? So stupid question lah. So now it's 60, right? Half-life 24. Then 24 second before, so it go backward lah. So before it should be double or 120. Okay, half-life is 24 second. So it go before. Before means double here or 120. Okay, 43. Also very straightforward. So the answer, I think you should able to understand. Half-life of carbon 6,400 years. These carbons are very long life, and you know, half-life 6,400 years. An artifact has been discovered. The activity of carbon left 1/4 fraction, given in fraction. When given in fraction, so you start with 1, go to half, then 1/2 divide by 2 again, go to 1/4. So this one 6,400 because half life 6,400. So you go to 1/4 means 1 time, 2 time lah. So 2 times 6,004, so you get 12,800 years. So okay, huh? So not difficult, like easy to understand, huh? Okay, 44. Understand the answer, okay? A radioactive source has a half-life 12 hours. How long does it take 75% to decay? The sentence put in a such a way that now they ask you, it takes how long for the 75% to decay? You want 75% to decay, so meaning that the remainings must be left 25% only. You want 75% to decay, ma? So left 25%, no? So left 25 means 150/25. So 2 times only, 2 half-life. If given in percentage, you start with 100, become half is 50, become half is 25. So each one is 12 hours, so it's 24 hours, okay? Yeah. You're still around now, all these people, you know, still around one lot. Li Ka Chuan, still around not? Li Ka Chuan? Li Ka Chuan, Li Ka Chuan, this fellow, I think, study AMAX. Tomorrow AMAX, isn't it? Yo, Li Ka Chuan still here lah. You got listen to me or not, Li Ka Chuan? Yeah, must listen nah, Li Ka Chuan. Okay, thank you. All right, come, let's move on now. 9 o'clock, I stop now, don't worry. Those who want to study, one can study, okay? 9 o'clock. Okay, 45. Okay, question 45, this was one of the SPM questions, so be careful. Because this question involving background reading one, you know. Okay, what is background reading, by the way? Hua Su Meng, please come out. Hua Su Meng, please. What is background reading? Can you tell me what is background reading? Background reading is what?
It's produced by radioactive materials from Earth and surrounding.
Surrounding now. Okay, good. Thank you very much. Okay. This radioactive come from the surrounding, from air, sunlight, lens, water, all this. Okay. So this background reading cannot be counted one, you know, it's like zero error log, so you need to minus it one, you know, okay? So you do like this, background reading recorded 40, this 40 is zero error, you need to minus one. A radio of this source is placed near the tube. The reading is 280, this 280 not correct one, you know, so the correct one you must minus 40, minus the background reading, so it's supposed to be only 240. After 3 hours, its reading dropped to 70 count per minute. 70 also not accurate one, minus the zero error 40. So it's 30. Actually, the actual reading is 240, start with 240, then ended with 30. Understand? That's why you put here, 240, 120, 60, 30, or say half lah. So after 3 hours, might say from 240 drop to 120, 120 to 60, 60 to 30. Okay. So three half line here, 1, 2, 3. Three half line equal to 3 hours because you say after 3 hours, right? So three half line here is 3 hours. So one half line is 1. So the answer is 1. Okay. So the answer is 1 hour, okay? Make sure you understand this question. Must understand it? No. Jayin. Jayin disappeared already. Still there or not? Jayin. Tan Jayin.
Yeah, I'm here. Yeah.
Understand? Tan Jayin. Tan Jayin, do you understand?
Understand.
Understand, Okay, thank you. All right, next. Question 40. Okay, another simple question. Paper show half-life and initial masses of two radioactive P and Q. So got two, P half-life 10 days. Initial mass 1 gram. Q half-life is 5 days, you know. Initial mass 2. How long take time to become same mass? Okay, you do calculation like this long. So for Q, right? You started with 2 gram. 2, after 5 days, it become 1. Another 5 days become 0.5. So 10 days become 0.5. Then for P, started with 1 gram, you say 1, but half-life 10 ma. So exactly after 10 days, it becomes 0.5. So it's same log, you see, here after 10 days, 0.5. Here after 10 days, also 0.5. So the time taken to become the same means 10 days, okay? Then, we seen, understand? We seen?
Understand.
Yao we seen, understand?
Understand.
Good. Okay, very shy to talk. I know, very shy to talk. Shy to use a microphone to talk. Yeah? 47. After 47, we stop. Okay. Three different rays PQR admitted from radioactive substance. The following table show the characteristics. Reflection of gold leaf. You put it under gold leaf. Unchained means no charge one. R decreases. When got respond to the gold leaf means must be alpha. Got only alpha got respond with gold leaf one. So these two, we don't know what is that. Confirm this one is alpha. Okay. Spark counter, no spark. This one produce spark. Confirm alpha. Because only alpha can produce spark. Alpha got charge. Ionization strong. And then from this diagram, even easier. You see all the light straight is alpha. Okay. The light curve and more curve, so it's beta. This one not continue one a little bit, a little bit, a little bit like that. So it's gamma. So from here, you know already lah. This one is alpha, R is alpha, Q is beta, P is gamma. Correct not? Penetrating power, so can confirm lor. Ripple stop. Stop by a few millimeter of this one aluminium, this one lead, right? So you know already, huh? So go answer the question now. Okay, so remember this, huh? Now question. Okay, P is what? Q is what? Apple Lau. P is what? Q is what? Apple? State the natural, natural characteristics of P and Q. Now come again, Apple.
P is gamma.
Q
is gamma. Q is beta.
Yes, correct. Very good. Thank you. Nature characteristics means the name lah. P is gamma. Q is beta. Okay. Next. Which of the ray has the strongest penetrating power? Strongest penetrating power, Song Ho Man. Which one is strong?
PV.
Yes. P, because P is gamma. Okay. And explain why P can't produce spark in spark counter. Why? Why P cannot produce spark in the spark counter? P is gamma. Why? Why cannot? Okay, let's hear from somebody from here. Chuk sampai pensan, don't know whose name is that. Brian, Mr. Brian. Brian, are you there? Brian, Brian, can you come out a while? Brian?
Yes.
Okay, Brian. Why P cannot produce spark in the spark counter? Why P cannot? Why P cannot produce spark in the spark counter? P is gamma. Why gamma cannot produce spark, Brian?
No charge.
Yes, correct. Because it does not have any charge. If no charge, that definitely cannot produce spark. Okay, thank you, Brian. Correct. So the answer is P is neutral. No charge lah, neutral. Okay. Here in 47 state natural characteristic, not writing P. Okay, Jayin, if this question I ask natural characteristics of ray, you can say P is gamma, or you can say electromagnetic wave also, okay? Okay, Ken. If the question said, what is the natural characteristics of gamma? And then only you can write electromagnetic wave lah. If the question say natural characteristics of P, then you can say gamma. You can also say electromagnetic wave lah. Jayin? Okay, understand lah, Jayin. Thank you very much for asking the question. Good question, Jayin. Okay. So this one settled lah. Yeah, thank you, sir. Okay, thank you, Jayin. All right, next. Ray P and Q cannot be detected by gold leaf. What is the reason? I ask you to explain why P and Q cannot be detected by gold leaf electroscope. Why? Why PQ cannot be detected by gold leaf electroscope? And now, here from Chuan He. Chuan He, la. Chuan He, are you there?
Yes, yes.
Chuan He, why PQ cannot be detected by gold leaf electroscope? What is the reason now? They ask you why. Why cannot?
No ionizing power.
Yes, very good answer. Because, not to say no power, no ionization power. No, we say very weak. We don't say no. Okay. Very weak ionization power. Okay. Very weak ionizing power. Lah, ionization power. Okay. Huh? Cannot be detected because weak ionizing power, ionization power. Okay. All right, next. Why R produce thick and straight thread in the cloud chamber? Why R can produce the light or straight one and very thick, thick and straight thread in the cloud chamber? Why? Why then? Okay, come, let's hear from R. Jiu Tong. Jiu Tong, ah. Why are produce thick and straight thread in the cloud chamber?
Because it has strong ionizing power.
Yes, very good. Very good answer. Perfect answer, Jiu Tong. Thank you very much. Okay. Because it has strong ionizing power and produces lots of ion for condensation of alcohol vapor. Okay. It has very strong ionization power and then produce a lot of ion for the condensation of alcohol vapor. Okay, you must have a lot of ion, or positive, negative ion, so that the alcohol vapor can condense on it. After alcohol vapor condense on it, so it will form smoke, something like smoke where you can see the track. Okay, yeah. So I stop here for 9 o'clock. Okay, let you all finish all your exam already. Then we can focus to do more. No, some of you, the heart also not here. Okay. So come back here. So we stop at 9 o'clock tonight. Okay. Right, so yeah, form five already. So form five, whether you got exam or no exam, so you must also find some time to study, because this few months is a critical month for you, you must study, okay? No matter how difficult, so you must make sure you study cannot get 2 hours, you study 1 hour also can. You cannot study 2 subjects, you make 1 subject to study every day. Make sure you must have a plan, You plan yourself, okay? Make sure at least you study 1 subject every day. Maybe today you study physics, maybe tomorrow you study your bio. And another day you practice your MX, right? So you must plan yourself, Don't study blindly. Plan now. You still got a few months, This few months you really have to plan yourself. How to study, how to improve yourself so that you can, by next January, you are fully ready for your SPM. Okay, huh? All right, so I see you again next week. Okay, bye-bye.
Thank you, teacher.
Bye-bye, everyone. Bye-bye. Okay, bye-bye, huh? Yes, bye-bye, bye-bye.
Thank you, sir.
Yes, okay, bye-bye, bye-bye. Yeah, bye-bye everyone. Bye-bye.